this year.
Yes.
Why would you pick the winter to walk across Canada?
I run hot, so.
Okay. Minus 20 doesn't bother you.
I've still yet to wear long johns. This is what I wear every day, pretty much. So.
Listen, Warren. I'd like to ask you, what was your reason for doing this? What sparked the idea? And what did you have to do to get it going? Like, how many months were you in preparation?
Well, the idea came years and years ago, and then it was the quote from our Prime Minister that said, the reason why we are fighting veterans so much in court right now is because they're asking for more than we're willing to give.
Now, what does he mean by a statement like that?
I don't know, but I felt very disrespected. I'm sure a lot of Canadians did too.
Does it seem to indicate that the service of the veterans wasn't worth enough? In other words, like he doesn't value that service?
That's where I would go with that, but you know, I'm not a veteran. I just honor those that are. My grandfather fought in the war. So, you know, we fought for what we have as Canadians. And a lot of men and women died for us, people that they don't know. And a life is most precious. There's no dollar sign on a life.
For our democracy.
Yeah.
Listen, when you started out, where was the first part? Where did you leave from?
Kelowna, BC, just by the airport.
Okay.
So it's just over 2,000 kilometers now.
How many k's a day would you say you walk?
With no weight on it, 35 to 45.
That's not bad. So you're going about 8 hours a day?
1.5 kilometers, 2 kilometers every 15 minutes.
Now, once you complete the journey, I imagine you've gone to Dayton to arrive.
I'm not too sure. There's quite a few people that want me there for the 14th. But, you know.
14th of February?
Yeah.
Wow.
that's pretty, it's pushing it.
It is pushing it.
That's pushing it. Like, I might have to start running.
And when you get there, what are your plans?
I have no plans. I have not planned out any of this trip.
So you're kind of going on a whim and a gut feeling.
Really. My gut feeling, my hope, my faith. And that's what I set out to do, was kind of, you know, bring some hope and some faith back to Canadians while doing this. You know, because I feel veterans are not asking for more than I can give, and I feel a lot of other Canadians feel the same way. So.
Let's talk about the faith aspect for a second, because obviously you're carrying a cross around. Why would you have chosen a cross for veterans?
Well,
my initial thought was because you see graveyards with crosses up in the fields of veterans and poppies and stuff. So
yeah,
I was just into what was your...
It's the veterans' cross, like, as they put on the graves. So I just wanted to show my respects to all our fallen.
Symbolic of them. There's also the quote about carrying the burden and the cross as well.
I've always said, you know, if I could take away somebody's pain, I'd gladly do it. And, you know, that's just me.
Carry the weight.
Carry the weight, yes, I would. For sure.
What was the other question I was going to ask? This will all be edited, so I'll stop instead. Don't worry about it. How you got around to making it. Do you want to do a little bit of a history about the making of it? And
It's about 80 pounds.
What's inside of the white? Like, is it a just
white? Just a frame, just a small, small wood frame. Actually, when I bought the plywood, I bought the kind of stuff I could find. As I was loading it up into the vehicle, I saw the sticker on it that said Patriot Lumber Products. Revolution Club.
That was a sign of them, wasn't it?
Right? So, that was pretty neat.
Now, I notice on your foot you've got what looks like a cast. Have you been going through a lot of strain doing this?
Actually, my other ankle hurts more than my broken ankle.
Mm-hmm.
I've got torn ligaments in my left ankle. Mm-hmm. So I've got that in a brace, and it causes more pain than the broken
ankle. That still didn't deter you?
Nope.
You're on a mission.
Nope.
You guys have any questions or anything you think I should be asking that I've missed? Well, I'm trying to get everything in, but maybe you've got some more.